So this work proposes the system SOL, which is short for second order laboratory. The system SOL is a tool, a Haskell-based tool for analyzing confluence and determination of second order computation rules derived from second order algebraic theory or a certain calculus. And the confluence checking is based on high order version of Knuth and Bendix's critical pair checking method and using an extended high order pattern unification method called FCU. And this has also a powerful enough high order termination checker. And if one can prove the confluence termination of a certain calculus, then it implies also the decidability of calculus. What this means is explained in this talk. And in the paper, I have demonstrated usefulness of the system SOL through 8 sample high-order programming language-related calculi, such as Paaprotokin and global state, and Mojave's computational meta language, linear lambda calculus, and their variations. And so in this talk, I pick up one of the simplest examples, namely the example of monad. A monad in Haskell style is a structure having two operations, return the bind, satisfying these three rules. And this is, I think, well known. But the following fact, perhaps less known, namely, the theory of monad is decidable. By theory, I mean equation theory of monad generated from these three rules. And so more precisely, this means that the question is given two well-typed terms, S and T, consisting of return bind and variables. Is an equation S equal T derived from these three rows? This question is actually decidable, meaning that there exists a terminating algorithm answering yes or no for any equation. How can I prove this? Actually, I have asked this question to various programming language researchers in Japan, but no one has clearly answered this question. But they believe that this is decidable. But I can now, in this talk, I show you how this is proved by using rewriting method. So what is rewriting method? Is that by using rewriting method, first we orient these equation rules as a rewrite rule from left to right. And then we analyze the property of this rewrite system. What kind of property we should analyze is that confluence and the Sturm normalization properties. Confluence just means that if there's a divergent computation passes, then such divergence can commute by further rewriting in many steps. And Sturm normalization means just termination, but in a strong sense, meaning that any computation passes are finite, and they end at a certain term, which are called normal forms. And then, these two properties also implies a desirable property of a calculus, namely, there always exist unique normal forms because any term has a normal form because of strong normalization, and such normal forms are unique because of confluence property. And this property can also be used to give a decidable proof method of arbitrary equation and actions, which means that now we regard the rewrite system C as an unoriented equation action, just forgetting orientation. Then the deducibility of equation from this action can be checked by rewriting method. So what is rewriting method? Proof by rewriting. What is proof by writing is just the deducibility of equation can be checked by just rewriting both sides equations to the normal forms. Then we check whether these normal forms are equal or not. If these are equal, then we can conclude that this original equation is derivable. If not, this is not derivable. Why this method is valid is that so we have assumed that the system is strong normalizing. Hence, we can always compute the normal forms in finite term. In this sense, decidable. And also, we have also obtained the unique normal form property. Hence, this proof method works. So this is a way of proving decidability of equation theory by rewriting method. But now, so the central question is that to ensure how to prove confluence and termination, strong normalization of a given calculus. So now let's turn into the problem on monad as an example. And then, so now we want to try to prove strong normalization of these three groups. And maybe a naive way to prove termination of this kind of rules is to assign certain weights to terms which are decreasing in each rule, such as the size of terms. But such a kind of weight-based proof doesn't work in general in higher case because, so for example, let's look at the first rule and suppose the case that k contain many y, such as 10 times y. Then, in the right-hand side, this x is copied 10 times, which means that the size of term is increased in that case. Hence, this kind of weight-based proof doesn't work, although it's very difficult to find a good weight, which is decreasing in each rule. So this is a bad way. But the standard way to prove the termination of this kind of higher-order rules is to use the deducibility method originated by Tate Girard. And actually, Lindley and Stack has proved that termination of these rules by finding a suitable reducibility predicate. And my method used in the my solar system is similar, but a slightly more generic way, meaning that I chose the general schema criterion developed by Frederick Branke in many years ago. So this is based on computability argument by Tate, and this is not designed for particular related rule. This is defined for generic related rule, and also this criterion just checks various syntactic and type condition of related rule, such as positivity of types and accessibility, safe use of recursive calls and meta variables, and so on. And this is suitable for automation. Hence, I chose this criterion and I implemented this in my solar system. And one surprise is that, and also, so this criterion works well in various examples as far as I checked. But this is not complete, of course, because decidability. Termination is an undecidable property, but this works well. And anyway, so I'll show you how these rows can be proved to be strongly normalizing by using solar system. So the first step to use solar system is to write a Haskell script describing rewrite rules using solar's DSL. Realized by template Haskell feature. So this keyword shows that the beginning of source DSL. And inside of so this bracket is the word of source. And I chose a natural mathematical meta language to describe this kind of rewrite rules. And for designing solves DSL. So as you see, so these are exactly the same as informal description of so these rules. So this is a practically important issue to describe relatively naturally. And anyway, then the next step is to invoke just a source command SN in GHCI. Then source checks all the conditions of general schema criterion. And this case, all conditions are satisfied, which shows the termination. So this termination is actually ensured by the theory of general schema. But anyway, this case shows termination. And then next, we try to show confluence. And again, we just invoke the one command cry for critical pair checking. Sol enumerates all possible critical pairs and checks the joinability of these. And in this case, Sol enumerates five possible critical pairs, but all are joinable. What this means that? This means that in the rows of derived rules of monad, there are these five possible overlapping situations happened in derived rules. This means that there are terms that admit two ways of different reduction. And for example, let's see this case. So this case, this term admits one reduction by applying associative rule, which just moves this bracket to right. But there's another way to rewrite this term by rewriting this underlined subterm by applying unit rule. So this shows a certain critical situation that may break the confluence. But by further rewriting from this to this by applying just unit rule, we actually get so commutation. So this means that this critical pair, so these are called critical pair, the critical pair are joinable. And other cases are similar. And this shows local confluence in uniting term. And with the strong normalization and Newman's lemma known in uniting theory, this concludes the confluence of the whole system. Hence, so we can conclude confluence. So actually, how we could obtain so these diagrams are just actually by computing overlapping using higher order unification. Actually, compute such overlapping situation by using unification process. And then we can conclude that the theory of monad is decidable. So this is a rewriting method to show decidability. And I applied this methodology to other problems, such as algebra theory of global state, various lambda calculi, etc. And of course, this methodology is not complete. Sometimes succeeds, but sometimes fails. But so this result so may show that this methodology can be one candidate of a good tool in the toolbox of programming language research. And these are results on ICFP side. So why I said ICFP side is that, so this work is also related to another conference held here, namely FSCD. So this work is actually, so I'm actually very happy to present my work, this particular ICFP conjunct with FSCD, because my ultimate research goal is to present as a good theory and practice which are beneficial for both worlds. And for the FSCD side, how this result is related is that FSCD community has collected various confluence and termination problems as databases. And I have tried to apply my system to the problem in database. And the current status is that Sol could prove a check automatically higher order 93 termination problem in termination database and 82 confluence problems. And this looks fairly good score. Hence, I decided to participate the competition held in this FSCD, namely termination competition, the conference competition. And this competed for the number of automatically checking of conference and termination by a tool. So, and I don't know how my tool solve is effective, but I'm actually a challenger. So we are a challenger. I made a team to participate in this competition. And result will be shown soon, Friday and Wednesday. So please check it out. And finally, so final word I want to tell you is that the title of this my paper is How to Prove Your Calculus is Decided. So my actual hope is that, so let's prove your calculus is decided using my tool Solve. So the Solve system is uploaded already in my homepage. Please download and play with it. And maybe there are some points, some anchor points of usage of Solve. I'm always happy to assist you. Ask me directly by email or Slack about the Solve system and the usage. And I hope that the Solve is one of the tools to design future good calculus of programming language theory. Thank you very much.